Hey, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to another video. My name is Spencer Berke. If you're new here, today we're shooting a E46 M3. Really cool car, super clean build. Let's check it out.
I think what happened was is we linked up through a Facebook group.
Yes.
Correct. And I think it's really cool how that group brings so many people together.
Absolutely.
Whether it's questions about the cars or meeting up in person. I appreciate you taking the time to do this to show us your car.
Yeah, thank you. My name is Frank. This is my 05 E46 M3. Pretty simple car, nothing crazy done to it. Basic bolt-ons, suspension, wheels, seats, custom roll bar. Wheels are Volk T37s. They are 18 by 9.5 plus 22 square, 10 mil spacer in the rear. And 265/35 RS4 hand cooked tires.
This setup, like I said, to me, I thought was just beyond clean.
Thank you.
Like, you see a lot of E46s that tend to go crazy with colors and everything. What's the factory color on this car?
This is a silver gray.
Silver
gray. This car's actually all original paint, everything except for the front bumper and the trunk.
What suspension are you on?
Actually, ISC M1s.
Really?
Same as you have on
I
your
I have the same ones. Yep. Represent, man, that's awesome.
3.4 degrees camber in the front.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's aggressive, man.
Yeah, mostly for track, and I mostly drive the car around town locally and then a couple track days a year, so I didn't want to change it up, so I left it there, but no issues with tire wear or nothing like that. So
how about the brake setup on the car?
Porsche conversion kit.
Really?
Yeah, OEM ZCP rotors all around, and then Porsche 986 calipers with Hawk pads.
And then you have hand cooked tires on here.
Yes.
Well, how do you like those tires?
I love them. They wear great. They're great in the rain. I did a track day at NJMP in New Jersey and downpoured and not an issue.
How about the interior? Looks like you have a lot done to it. You did a couple things, huh?
Recaro SPG XLs, Schroth harnesses, and Bayside Fabrications custom roll bar.
And that,
it's a one piece bolted.
And that roll cage is color matched to the car too.
Yes. It's like powder coated, but we tried to get as close to the silver gray as possible. It's got like a little tint of blue into it, but it's really hard to see when next to the car.
It contrasts really well. Are you a sunroof kind of person?
No.
No?
No. That's actually one of my winter plans for this year. I'm hoping to get rid of the sunroof, do a carbon roof. So
oh, you do a conversion?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, just to get more headroom, it helps with the helmet at the track. It'll look a lot better, I think.
That makes sense. And what shifter do you have on this
RTD.
Car? RTD. RTD shifter?
Yeah, the tall race shifter. Yeah, probably one of my favorite mods. It's a little annoying on the street sometimes if you drive a lot, but just local driving here and there on the track, absolutely love it.
I'm assuming you got used to it pretty quickly.
Oh, yeah. After like 10 minutes of driving, you start to really appreciate the technology behind the shifter itself.
Can we pop the hood? I want to see
Absolutely.
The engine too.
It's a little dirty.
It's meant to be used.
Yeah, she's driven.
Yeah. How many miles are on the car?
106.
Nice. These cars have rod bearing issues, right?
Yes. So like I said, a little dusty.
Mm-hmm. What have you done to the car maintenance wise?
Vanos is done. Subframe was done with the PS Design plates. The whole Bajon system for the Vanos. Well, every bushing on the car has been replaced. Anything that really wears besides the rod bearings have been replaced. I do an oil sample every 3,000 to 4,000 miles. So until the report shows that I need to, I'm gonna wait it out. But
do you feel like the car lacks any power, or are you pretty happy with where it's at?
I'm pretty good. I'm about 320-ish, 325 on a Mustang dyno. So,
okay.
Which is headers, full exhaust, and a Cassell Performance Tune. That's really, pretty happy with it.
So you have headers on this?
Yes, Beam World single-step headers.
I'm assuming that made a huge difference.
Yeah, big time. I went from the agency power headers to those, and I picked up about 15 wheel.
What's the trunk setup?
It's a status group, scores a trunk.
What exhaust are you running?
Super Sprint muffler with the status group RAS pipe and resonating section 2.
Okay, and then how about the rear diffuser?
That's Mile Composites. Pretty new to the whole E46 scene. He's out in Montreal,
mm-hmm.
and he makes awesome carbon fiber products.
What made you want to debadge the car?
I don't know.
Just because?
Yeah, I figure it's so hard to find that right placement on the CSL trunk without actually having the M3 CSL on a CSL trunk, so I figured just best to leave it off.
What does your license plate mean?
Side piece.
So that's what we figured.
Yeah, my wife thought it was a great idea because I spend so much time and money on the car. It's like my other girlfriend, so she calls it my side piece.
I see that you have some tracks here.
Yes.
What tracks have you been to so far?
New York Safety Track, kind of like a home track for me. Been there a bunch of times. Lime Rock and Thunderbolt and Lightning. I try to do 4 or 5 events a year.
Okay.
It's tough working in the car business. Saturdays are kind of a dead day for me. Can't do anything but work. So most track days are Friday, Saturdays, or Saturday, Sunday. So I try to get to a Friday or a Sunday event.
Having white wheels, is it hard to keep those clean?
Oh, it's a terrible idea.
Yeah, I've seen it. I've had it before, and I understand the pain.
Yeah, I love them. They add nice contrast to the car. They pop. So many comments and pictures. But yeah, it's like a second job keeping these things clean.
As far as future plans, what do you want to do to the car?
Definitely a carbon fiber roof.
Okay.
And then I would definitely like to do a carbon airbox, maybe cams. But that's down the line for sure.
Do you ever have any plans as far as like stepping into a different car in the future, or are you pretty hooked on the E46?
Once I feel this car is done, I want to get into a 997.1 six speed. Thought about the E92. I've actually had six of these. It's my sixth one.
Six E46s. Yeah.
So this is like the end all for me. I'm going to keep this one probably for a very long time. I tried to sell it, but not really in me to get rid of it. It's too tough.
I understand that completely, because this is a fine example of an E46, and I'm sure it's hard to find ones that are clean.
Super hard. And as they're getting older, they're getting more molested and ruined.
From my perspective, you know, I'm an E90 person and I love E46s. If someone was to go out to look for an E46, what's something they should look out for?
I think clean Carfax is one pretty big thing. And then also maintenance records. These things could get neglected. Even with low mileage, if they're absolutely been neglected, they could be a disaster for you and they could cost you a fortune. And sometimes a more expensive car is cheaper than a cheaper car. That makes sense.
I understand that.
Like, I paid a lot of money from this car from the original owner. But the way she maintained the car and all the records she had, and it was just spotless when I got it. And to me, it was worth the extra money to go with a cleaner example.
I can't say thank you enough for doing this. I appreciate it.
Thank you guys. I appreciate you guys taking your time. I know you're visiting New York, so
yeah,
so many better things to do, but I appreciate you guys coming and meeting up with me.
Of course. No problem, man. Thank you.
One first.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much.
Yes, push me, you guys. Thank you for coming.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Thank you.